Hello world, this is Max and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Battery has died on my Kawasaki Vulcan 900 after 4 years of riding. That's it, done. One day I came out, I wanted to go for the ride, I couldn't start. So it was time for a new battery. I'm gonna go through a few simple steps showing how you should activate and charge your new AGM motorcycle battery. I'm gonna do it for my motorcycle Kawasaki Vulcan 900, but it's gonna be pretty much the same for any motorcycle, ATV or scooter, wherever you use an AGM battery. If you haven't done it yet, do me a favor, go to the subscribe button, click it, hit the bell notification so you're not gonna miss any of my new videos. Thank you guys, I really appreciate it. Don't activate your AGM battery unless you watched this video. First thing first, when you buy an AGM battery, you either get it factory activated or bottle supplied. If you have a factory activated battery, it is filled with electrolyte, sealed and charged. In this case, you just install it on your bike and you're done. Then you don't need to watch this video further. Instead, check another video where I show how to install the battery on my bike, Kawasaki Vulcan 900, and there is a link right here at the top right of the screen. I have a dry battery with electrolyte supplied in the plastic container. So this is what we got in the box, electrolyte and the battery. Before you activate the battery, make sure that the foil sealing strip is in place with no damage. When you unseal it, you need to activate and charge it right away, otherwise it will begin to oxidize. That is not good for the battery. Activation of an AGM battery is pretty straightforward, but you need to keep in mind a couple of things to make it right. Let's do it now. Never use anything else to activate the battery other than the supplied container with the electrolyte. It has a high concentration of sulfuric acid, more concentrated than the electrolyte for conventional batteries, and it would be unsafe to use something else. Supply containers also have exact amount of the electrolyte required. Make sure you read the instructions that came with the battery. Never smoke when you activate the battery, and also wear gloves and protective eyewear. Keep the battery on the level surface and remove the electrolyte container from the plastic bag. Remove the strip of caps from the container. Don't throw it away as we will use it later. Do not pierce or open the foil seals from the electrolyte container. Do not separate the containers one from another. Now we will remove the foil sealing strip from the battery. This is the most important part now. Place the electrolyte container with the foil seals face down into the cell filler ports of the battery. Hold the container level and carefully push it down to break the foil seals, like this. Electrolyte will start to flow into the battery, so you're gonna see air bubbles inside the container. Do not tilt the container. Electrolyte is flowing, so we're good. If no air bubbles are coming up, tap the container slightly, like this, but don't tilt it. Leave it for about 20 minutes, usually 15 to 20 minutes, until the containers are completely empty. After 15-20 minutes, check if container cells are emptied completely. If not, slightly tap the container or battery a couple of times So electrolyte flows into the battery again. In our case, it is pretty good. It's got empty and we don't have any electrolyte left inside. When it is empty, remove the container from the battery. And then fully insert this the strip with sealing caps that we took off the container into the battery filling ports. Do it by hand. Do not use a hammer or any other tools. Don't force it too much. Just gently push it in. Make sure it's fully sealed and it is flat even with the top of the battery. And from now on, we do not open it ever. At this point, we need to let the battery to sit for about an hour if the rating of the battery is less than 18 amps hours. That would be the case for the most motorcycle batteries. And it's going to be the case with us as well. We have 10.5 amp hours battery. If you have a battery with a high performance rating, more than 18 amp hours, then let it sit for about 2 hours. Why do we need it? We need it to allow the battery glass mats to absorb the electrolyte. After 1 hour, the final step is to charge the battery. So before we do that, let's take a look how many volts we have at this point. So it shows 12.6, 12.7. Awesome. Usually after you activated the battery, the charge is about 70 to 80%. So we need to put it in the charger and then we charge it. We need to select AGM battery type. So let's do this. So I selected AGM battery type right here. I have blue light showing at the top of AGM. And right now it shows 25% charge. The charger should be able to provide at least 12.8 volts. I use this NOCO Genius G1100 charger and it provides 14.5 volts charging. So we need to charge the battery until it shows 100% on the charger. Now the battery is fully charged. We have a solid green light on the charger and now we can install it on the bike. Let's check what the reading is on the battery right now. So let's connect the meter. And it shows 1297. That's perfect and we gotta install it now. If you want to see how I install it on my Kawasaki Vulcan 900, please check out my next video. Thanks for watching this one. Ride safe.